this out.
I want to show you something.
We were the guys that will walk past. Now it's our time to take over. The masters of our own fate. We are reborn. We are FHB.
A cult is a social group that lives by a strict set of rules or a belief system that is often created by the group's leader. These leaders often have persuasive personalities and have the ability to manipulate their followers into doing their bidding.
Did Jesus look like the Son of God? No one thought so, except a few people in his day.
Tell me in a sentence who you are.
Nobody. I'm nobody.
I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. There are no gods, no masters, just me.
So it's not surprising that these groups often commit violent crimes to forward their agenda or live a lifestyle that is frowned upon by modern society.
April 19th, 1993, a fire broke out.
This far out of the country without fire hydrants, you have to haul all your water. It's just a very bad scenario.
Let me say that our mission here at this time is about to come to a close.
A mansion in a quiet, affluent suburb of San Diego. 21 women and 18 men had taken their own lives.
Oh, God!
Oh, my God! Cut the tape!
I think the chap's dead!
I'm challenging you to get two more of your boys. I'm challenging you, FHB versus SWJ. Loser leaves town.
What?
That's right, a Civil War elimination tag.
Oh my God, ladies and gentlemen, challenging the SWJ roster, a Civil War elimination tag.
You sound like you've been drinking the proverbial Kool-Aid here.
So my eyes are open now, and I've been shown the way, the right way, by Mr. Rogers, and I'm going to take this place by storm.
Mr. Rogers? I feel like I'm in Mr. Rogers' neighborhood. I'm out of here.
It's not funny. It's Mr. Rogers' neighborhood cult, this FHB gang of bullies. Challenging the SWJ roster.
That girl is poison. Never trust a big button smile. That girl is
and we're live, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Worcester, Massachusetts for an episode of Primetime Wrestling. I'm Dick McFly, joined by Brad Daveshaw.
What a show we have for you tonight.
Update. An inside look from the pages of the magazine.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this week's edition of the SWJ Update. We are just 1 week away from the big pay-per-view extravaganza, SWJ / FHB Deep Impact. Yes, indeed, next week somebody is indeed going out with a bang. Will it be FHB or will it be the SWJ? Only one league will remain at the end of the night when the smoke clears. The internet's abuzz and everybody's asking, who is Team Sweet Willie Johnson's fourth man going to be? Who will answer the bell? Will anybody ring? And, oh, I hate bells. Except for Richard Belzer. That guy's hilarious. But nonetheless, ladies and gentlemen, the SWJ makes its triumphant return to the Constitution State. And if you haven't already snagged a ticket, it's too late. The Deep Impact pay-per-view has sold out, but it's not too late to catch SWJ Live, ladies and gentlemen. If you're in the Hartford area, try to catch the Manfest Tour. That's right, ladies and gentlemen, the SWJ Manfest Tour 2018, coming to Hartford, Connecticut. If you've never been to a live SWJ event, then you are surely missing out, ladies and gentlemen. Just look at this fan footage from the Smack It Whack It Tour last month in Worcester, Massachusetts. Oh, baby, I would not want to miss out on this. Coming to the Hartford area, it's going to be, get this, the Spirit Squad versus the Bullet Club. Oh, my goodness, the NRA enthusiasts are out in full force these days. Can that varsity team, the Spirit Squad, protect the school grounds? Oh, golly, I hope so. And then, ladies and gentlemen, don't miss this one. It's Tillycum versus a SeaWorld trainer. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, this is a dated reference, but if you saw the Blackfish documentary, you know this feud's been heating up for a while. Oh, yippee. And then you're not going to want to miss the main event. This one really strikes close to home, ladies and gentlemen. Just take a look at this clip that's been lighting the internet on fire.
So I go inside, I politely say, hey, can I have a McRib meal? Large size with the Dr. Pepper. And the lady said, well, okay, that'd be $6.58. I said, ain't you forgetting something, ma'am? And she said, well, what? I said, you're supposed to offer me the extra McRib for a dollar when you buy the McRib meal. You ain't gonna believe it. She looked me up and down. And she said, well, don't look like you need the extra McRib. Excuse me,
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. It's yours truly, Sir Fart-A-Lot and my mom versus Ronald McDonald and that sassy McDonald's lady. Ladies and gentlemen, the SWJ Manfest Tour coming to Hartford, Connecticut. Don't miss out.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, originally we were scheduled to have the Saucy Chap versus the Gay Babadook, but after last week's incident, we're not going to have that. We're going to have a street fight.
Oh my God, I love a street fight.
Look at this, ladies and gentlemen. Team FHP. Or at least three of the four members. We got Jeff Bomber, the Tri-State Champion Alex Carvalho,
and M-E-K-R.
David John Rogers, the SWJ Heavyweight Champion. They're going to take on three members of the SWJ pro roster. It's going to be Aphrodisiac, Sergio, and Uncle Slam. And a quick medical update, Saucy Chap, you know, he did survive that fall from the tractor trailer, thank goodness. Our thoughts and prayers are with him, but it's going to be quite some time before we see the Chap again, I can assure you that. And the Gay Babadook, severe lacerations from the that power bomb through the windshield. Babadook's going to be out of action as well. And you can thank good old Team FHP for that nonsense.
Oh,
but look out!
Look at all the gold in that around that waist.
Look at this, ladies and gentlemen.
What is this?
Team SWJ jumps the rail, and we're going to get this thing started right here, right now.
Oh, wow. That's not fair. They didn't even wait for the match to start.
Oh, my God. They're taking the match to Team FHP. Look at this, ladies and gentlemen. Good guys in white, bad guys in black.
And this is the first time I've seen wrestling outside on the ring on the hard top.
I think they're at half court.
Of the hardwood, I meant.
My goodness, ladies and gentlemen. Look at this. We got a three-on-three street fight. Obviously, no tags needed in this one. Anything goes. The ref is out there, but I can assure you he's there just to make the pin.
Yeah, he's not there to...
And make the pin, he will. We got a one.
We got a two.
DJR's having a tough time trying to break it up. You gotta kick him.
Never been in a match before.
What is this? Oh, forearm to the back of the Aphrodisiac's head.
He loves his forearms.
Oh my goodness, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh my.
Last week you heard DJR challenge the entire Sweet Willie Johnson roster to that Civil War elimination tag. He says that there can only be room for one league, and that league should be FHP.
A loyalist. I like him.
And problem is, ladies and gentlemen, we got four men on Team FHB, and only three men have answered the bell on Team Sweet Willie Johnson. Look out, aphrodisiac flying clothesline. They need a fourth member. But after seeing the chap get thrown off that trailer, I wouldn't...
about the devastation.
I wouldn't be signing up to be taken on Team FHB, I'll tell you that.
Oh, no. I mean, look at this.
Goodness.
I mean, they're already crushing... what you want to be a part of?
Absolutely not. You know, you... Team FHB, you don't want to succumb to a bully, but I'm not going to sign up for that.
Sometimes you got to live to fight another day.
Jeez. Next week, ladies and gentlemen, it's the Civil War Elimination Tag. If FHB is victorious and the FHB does indeed come back, then Sir Fartalot, you're out of here, buddy. He's banned from the FHB. He lost the Loser Leaves Town. You know, that matchup.
He'll be right back on the streets.
I hate to say it, Brad Deschamps, but this could be the last episode of Primetime Wrestling in the history of Sweet Willie Johnson.
Yeah, I don't care. As long as the checks are getting cut. You didn't enjoy FHB? You used to have a lot of crazy shit there, like blow.
More blow and than you could shake a stick at. And while that may sound appealing, you can't live that lifestyle in the long term. You burn yourself out. I prefer this gay stuff at Sweet with Billy Johnson.
This erotica?
Homoerotica. Meanwhile, these six men are just going to war here, but you have to wonder, it's got to be only a matter of time before...
He's tapping.
Took the ref out.
It doesn't matter, he doesn't see it then.
Oh my goodness, I was going to say, it's only a matter of time. You know Gorgeous Boy just will stick his nose in this one.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
And like I said, Sweet Willie Johnson, they're a man down. Three men.
Who's going to answer the bell for them? Who's left?
No, I'm telling you, it ain't the Babadook, and it's not going to be the Sausage. But meanwhile, Aphrodisiac bringing another table into the ring here.
This is a street fight, folks.
He's got a second table. He's got to be careful. Last, he took that table out. David Diamond. Oh! DJR powerbombed him right through the damn thing. Ooh, a spear from Uncle Slam onto Alex onto the table. Jeff Bombers just counting the lights. And Afro, like you said, Brad, setting that table up.
Yeah, I mean, Jeff Bomber. Oh, maybe you could get the advantage here.
What the
table
heck?
Against him.
Jeff Bomber setting him up here.
Oh.
Look out.
He smashed his face into that table.
Oh my goodness. Meanwhile, look out.
Uh-oh.
Oh, aphrodisiac face first. Excedrin headache number 5 from aphrodisiac. Oh, Jeff Bomber trying to climb back in here.
Oh. Is really working on Uncle Slam.
Sergio knocks Jeff Bomber right back to the outside. But yeah, as you said, we got a 2-on-1 in the ring here. Alex and DJR teaming up on Slam. You know, we saw that classic last week, Uncle Slam and Aphrodisiac, last man standing. The two men bonded. Uncle Slam felt that Afro, you know, finally earned his respect.
Yeah, it was getting a little gross.
He shook hands. But then obviously DJR came down and stuck his nose in. It lit up the locker room, I'll tell you that.
Yeah, I wonder how much he got fined for all that damage.
Jesus. Not enough, because they're still out here.
Well, you need to make the check to pay for it now.
Hey, we got a pin on the outside. You got to get over there, ref.
The ref's going...
Come on, you're taking all day here.
You need to count to the 15.
Oh, of course it's only a 1. Took you 15 seconds to make it to the outside.
Oh no.
Oh, stereo slop drops. Hey, Sergio's got a ladder here. What the heck?
What's he doing?
He's going to the top.
Unnecessary, there's no belt up there.
Oh my goodness! Alex meets him up there! Twist of fate off the ladder! Jesus!
Christ.
Pin him. It's over.
My goodness, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, he wants slam.
Next week, all the marbles are on the line. But it looks like they're going for it right here tonight. Twist of fate. Wow, what a beauty.
I mean, if you do enough damage to your opponent, they're not going to be 100% next week.
You're absolutely right about that. This could be more important than anything. Alex knocking Afro off the top. Now Afro, Alex is going to take flight. No, slam breaker. Unbelievable, ladies and gentlemen. Look at that.
Slam breaker.
A beautiful slam breaker off the top of the ladder. You know, the momentum, the momentum of a victory tonight, combined with the potential damage he whiffed, the botchamania.
Oh, but he didn't back of the skull.
Didn't miss that one.
Oh my. Oh, Jeff. Got a second win.
Man, these guys get so mad with the chair shots. They just completely stop selling. But as I was saying, you know, the momentum combined with the amount of damage you put on the opposing team. Well, there's a guy in the third row I just turned around. He's drinking beer out of his sneaker.
That was awesome.
What the heck was that? I gotta concentrate on the match here, but I've never seen that before. Good lord. Uncle Slam. Oh! Sergio putting Jeff Bomber through a table here.
Look at the hits in the front row.
Oh, I love it. Take the top off, purple shirt.
About DJ
on. Oh my goodness. Looking good tonight. Super heavyweight division. Oh! Shake, rattle, and roll from Sergio Bomber Bin Laden.
Yes.
Now, where the hell did Jeff Bomber and Alex go? DJR forced to fend for himself here, but he's got the table.
And by himself. I mean, he's by himself.
He's by himself. I can't believe it. Sergio taking out a second table here. What the hell are the other guys doing? I thought that Team FHB had the numbers advantage. Right now, we're looking at a 3-on-1 edge from Sweet Willie Johnson for wrestling, and I love it.
You are a sick, sick man.
Look at this.
The double? Oh, no.
Hey, what's he doing? Oh, my goodness. He's stacking the tables.
No.
And he's going to stack the odds in SWJ Pro's favor. Afro taken to the top here. Is he going to fly? Whoa. Sergio just slipped. He almost hit Afro. Afro sprinting over. Whoa. Good lord. DJR. Through both tables. And where's Jeff Bomber? They're having a good rest under the ring. Oh my goodness, Jeff Bomber and Alex, you gotta get in there. Finally, with the chair. All right. What am I saying, all right? I hate those guys.
Yeah, no.
Still, 3-on-1, nobody likes to see that. Unless
not
it's
especially.
Unless it's me and two guys and my wife.
As long as.
Whoa.
One of the two guys?
Hallelujah. It goes Afro. Oh. You know, after DJR went through those two tables, I thought Sweet Willie Johnson had this thing in the bag. But Alex and DJR, they're now taking it to the aphrodisiac. Back and forth, the momentum shifts.
I can't believe DJR is up after going through two tables.
My goodness. Afro's got something in mind here. Taking him to the top.
All the way to the top.
The tippity top.
He's going to bring him down slow.
Ladies and gentlemen, he's going to set him up for a superplex maneuver.
Oh my God.
And he nailed it. Pin.
Go for the pin.
Oh, we knew it. We knew it was only a matter of time before Gorgeous Boy just showed his face. That gorgeous face.
That gorgeous. What you gonna do?
Oh, nut shot.
Aphrodisiac, that might be it.
Kicked him right in the bonker. My goodness. And now DJR setting him up. Easy pickings. It's the numbers advantage, like we said.
Oh,
4-3. Exceptional forearm. And it's all downhill from here.
Is he going to pin him?
He's setting him up for the poacher plex.
Oh, no.
Yep. He's signaling to the crowd. He's locking it in.
If he gets the hands locked.
Oh, my God. It was the poacher plex buster.
Yep.
Sometimes ladies and gentlemen, that's it. Good night. And until Sweet Willie Johnson gets a fourth man, I don't see any hope. We're going to be out of a promotion. We might be out of a job.
Again. Like, what are we going to do?
I quit FHB. They're not going to hire me back.
I got fired. I got caught up in it.
That's not good at all.
Can I go back?
Ladies,
go back?
I hope so. We're going to have a long talk with whoever's... Who's going to run the place? Sir Fartalot can't run it. He's banned. Oh, man. That's not a bad idea. I think I like this FHB thing. After all, that's a heck of an idea. Ladies and gentlemen, there's the mastermind, Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. Look at this, Team FHB. Look at this. It's like he's had this thing, planned for weeks.
Yeah.
Poacherplex.
What a devastating.
David John Rogers.
Variation of a suplex.
Unbelievable. You know he loves it when a plan comes together.
Uh-huh.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah.
You've done enough. This is
no,
that.
You haven't.
This
do
is the extra
more.
Damage we were talking about. Hey! Borges is signaling. John! John Michael Williams! John Michael!
No.
He answers the bell. He's going to answer the bell for Sweet Willie Johnson. Look at him. Ladies and gentlemen.
John grabbed the chair.
Coward! He's just doing what's right!
What's right?
And SWJ!
Sticking his nose right don't belong.
They've got their fourth man!
Unbelievable.
John Michael to the rescue!
Come on, Coward.
Unbelievable! Now it's a fair shot! Next week, Sweet Willie Johnson!